one moment. There are Zentarum up ahead. Around half a dozen.
Impressive eyes for a human. They are indeed Zents. One of them has the unfortunate luck of being a dead Zent. Considering our present company, it would be somewhat perverse if that fact worried any of us.
Very funny. You're right about the corpse, though. He's only recently dead. I can smell the freshness of the blood soaking the snow. Why are you staring at me like that?
You intrigue me. My studies have incorporated many strange and wonderful things, but never one such as you.
I am, uncomfortable with this talk of the dead. Liresa is what she is.
I greet you.
Yes? What do you want?
Gloomfang was a dragon of no small power. The wizard she spoke of must be mighty indeed to have earned her loyalty.
Well, whoever he is, this Archmage poses a threat to the entire Moonsea. Perhaps a time will come when Faerûn isn't constantly plagued by powerful spellcasters threatening the lives of common folk.
I share those sentiments. It was a wizard. A necromancer who did this to me.
Don't attempt to lay Faerûn's woes solely at the feet of mages. Are the blades of Mullmaster not warriors of the highest caliber?
Yes, and the Azuns rule with justice and dignity.
Well, I wish I could say the same for Selpharil and his Council of Blades.
I sense I have stirred up some bad memories, Greymane.
Well met.
Yes?
I greet you.
Hello.
Yes?
Sorry,
I cannot do that.
No can do.
I greet you.
Thank you.
pathetic. These Sladai grow more numerous by the day. You must have a death wish to be traveling these roads, at least without an army to back you up. I work best alone. The only allies a true swordsman needs are his blades. Tell me, stranger, what brings you so far from the safety of civilization?
Grazkan. One of the Sladai I fought on my way here squealed the name over and over. I suspect he must be somewhere close. You are either foolish or supremely confident. The latter is not a fault, provided one can match words with deeds. Regardless, Grazkan is your problem. He's mine.
So, Selfaro finally sent you after me. I should be pleased he hired the best.
He's paying well, and he promised it would be a challenge. I would never have accepted unless both those conditions were met.
You're welcome to try, assassin. I've been waiting for this moment a long time. I was once a blade. One of the ruling nobles of Momaster, and the only one not a puppet of Selfaro. He ordered me to eliminate a city official, a young woman, and I refused and was banished from the city. The High Blade has never forgiven me.
The High Blade displays surprising cowardice for a warrior of his reputation. Perhaps once I'm finished with you, I will teach him a lesson.
I've never seen a man's blades dance like that before, and I've sparred against the best Moonmaster has to offer. Even Selfaro will be sorely tested against that killer. Eventually he'd have overmatched me. He's only the second man I could say that about. The blades of Mowmaster must truly desire my death. None more so than Highblade Selfarl himself. She disappeared. I tried to warn her before I was chased out of Mowmaster. I never felt the need to hide. Now, they've sent assassins before and none have met with success. I can never return to Mowmaster, but I won't let Selfarl chase me out of the Moonsea. I'm sorry about this. The last assassination attempt was 5 years ago. As you wish.
Yes?
Hi.
Greetings to you.
I greet you. I greet you.
Hi there.
Well met. Well met.
Beyond to trap.
That was a nasty head wound. I'm glad I could treat it before any permanent damage was done.
So, this is the one they're all talking about.
Apparently, One Hand himself signed the arrest warrant.
Quiet. They are waking up.
I greet you, my child.
Another one of Wax's victims. Yes, my commiserations. If I ever get free of this place.
Well met, friend. It brings me great sorrow to see another poor soul imprisoned in this most foul of places. It has been a 10 day since I danced under the light of Sehenim Moonbow alongside my fellow elves.